Welcome back to the Morning Blend. Okay, so get this. Research shows that watching romance films releases stress hormones and makes us feel calmer. A really good love story apparently can also bring comfort. Film critic Ryan Jay is back to bring me comfort on this Monday morning. He's got a list of all types of romantic movies. Hey again, Ryan. Good to see you.
You too, thanks.
Look at you mixing it up. Before you had your Morning Blend background, now you've got your Ryan Jay Reviews movie background.
I'm all about a good theme. You know that, right?
I absolutely do. Oh, I have to mention, this is off topic. My daughter just rewatched all the Harry Potter movies and is a huge fan. So we were talking about you a lot this weekend.
Oh, that's so sweet. What house is she in?
What?
Is she Ravenclaw?
Oh,
Gryffindor?
I don't know. I wouldn't even think to ask her that. I'll have to ask her that.
Excellent.
Okay, I'll get back to you on that. All right, let's talk about romance movies. Is it okay if I mention my pick first?
Yeah, I wanted your pick. I know.
So you do?
I think so.
Okay, I have to admit, though, I was torn because I love so many, like The Way We Were and Out of Africa, but it is an epic movie. What do you think it is?
Gone with the Wind? Yes, right?
You're right on.
I think that defines what an epic romance is.
Yeah, I do too. It's so sweeping, the whole thing.
Mm-hmm. It really is. And it actually leads me to what my pick is for epic romance, which is the film Australia. And it is like Gone with the Wind, shot in a modern day time. It's filmed by director Baz Luhrmann, stars Nicole Kidman and Hugh Jackman. And it hits all the same beats that Gone with the Wind did. It has romance, drama, comedy, action, war, you know, it kind of has all those different genres blended into one in a very long runtime, but it also has that epic sweepingness like Gone with the Wind does for the Old South, what Australia does for Australia.
And it has your favorite girl in it too.
It sure does.
I love that one. That reminds me of The English Patient too. Okay, so that kind of hits your epic romance category. What about drama, romantic drama?
Right. With romantic drama, I feel like this is a really easy one because there is one film that comes down and is always the gold standard. Almost everyone agrees the best rom-drama is The Notebook. Ryan Gosling and Rachel McAdams, intergenerational. This one's a tearjerker, but it makes you feel like you're falling in love too. The chemistry that they share and the sweepingness of this romance really touches everyone who sees it.
Well, and they ended up being a real life couple too.
Yes, for a while. And we also see Gina Rowlands and James Garner in this. And I just love how it kind of crosses all generations and speaks to kind of renewed love over time.
Do you feel like it's a sad movie?
I think that there's, it definitely tugs at your heartstrings. And you may find it to be a tearjerker. Not as sad as some others, you know, certainly we could name, but it has that element to it for sure.
Great pick there. All right, talk about rom-com. What's your pick in this category?
Right, well, when it comes to rom-com, this is the most difficult one to choose because almost no one can agree on what the best rom-com is. There are so many good ones, and I really struggled picking one. But I chose one of my favorites that I think almost no one has seen and really want to recommend, which is Adam and Steve. What's so great about it, it's writer, director, and star Craig Chester, and it flips the rom-com upside down. So, you know, the typical rom-com formula is boy meets girl, boy loses girl, they reunite at the end, right? Here it's boy meets boy, and the stars of the film are a gay couple, and then their sidekicks, their best friends are the straight people. And so normally you see the gay best friends as the sidekicks in a rom-com. Here we've got it the other way around. Great story, great script, great performances. I love Adam and Steve.
I like that, Adam and Steve, and I've never seen it. I'm going to have to check that one out. We all have enough time, that's for sure. What about romantic action?
This is another one that's really fun. Romantic action comes from all different, you know, areas. And I picked one that was romantic action, but also has a bit of a sci-fi fantasy bend, Jupiter Ascending. Channing Tatum and Mila Kunis, and they have great chemistry, but you also have Eddie Redmayne in this, a great supporting ensemble cast of characters. It takes you to other worlds. The action and effects are phenomenal.
I find that there are so many great... Oh, do you think there will be a sequel to that one?
I was hoping there would be. I like this, but this one really tanked the box office. Not too many people saw this one. The budget was about $200 million, only made about $47 million domestically.
Oh,
so probably not a sequel.
Okay. Period romance. I bet this category was hard too.
this is hard. And I chose The Age of Innocence. Martin Scorsese, one of my favorite ones of his films, with Daniel Day-Lewis, Michelle Pfeiffer, Winona Ryder. We, of course, saw Daniel Day and Winona Ryder do The Crucible, another twisted kind of romance a few years later. But The Age of Innocence is one that you should not watch hungry. It is so exquisite. The food in this movie you'll fall in love with as much as you do the forbidden love between Michelle Pfeiffer and Daniel Day-Lewis. It's such an exquisite film. When we think about period, this takes place in like the 1870s, pre-Spanish flu, right? And it's so sweeping and so gorgeous. And the food and the costumes and the details, the flowers, every detail is just amazing.
Great recommendations. You came up with such an interesting list. I absolutely love it.
Thank you so much.
Now, do you have a virtual movie club coming up?
Yes, I was thinking it would be really fun, like we did last week with comedies, for people to go to my website, click on to ryanjreviews.com, click on the tab that says movie club, and write in and tell me what your favorite feel-good movie is this week. And on Friday, I'll reveal some of our viewers' answers.
Oh, I like that. Thanks for including all of our viewers in that. I love that you do that.
It's my pleasure. I love to interact with everybody.
Yeah, and we asked a question on Facebook about people's favorite romance of all time. So will you stick around and join us again in just a couple minutes?
Absolutely.
All right. Sounds good, Rye. I'll talk to you in a second. All right. You can like Ryan J on Facebook, follow him on Instagram and Twitter. And for his full movie reviews, you got to check out his website, ryanjreviews.com.